hand and say it's okay. Breathe a little deeper. Love a lot sweeter on yourself. You are enough. You are enough. Can't sleep and sleeping in. Taking space feels like a sin. Every step is a mistake. Every minute of your day planned out on how to stay small, subtle, innocent. So cold and frustrated. Never claim. Please breathe a little deeper. Love a lot sweeter on yourself. You are enough. You are enough. You're not alone.
You're not alone.
You're not alone.
You're not alone.
You're always home.
You're always home.
You're not alone.
Who left us not so much, or rather not only, with so many finished songs, as with the sense that he had more to say. From the outside, he seemed as if he was done, but he had so much more to say. Even after saying 1,000 words, I have 1,000 more to let out. One part of bad news, psychological researchers say, cancels 5 parts of good. One line of will and must, of take what you get, can cancel out a line of wish or would. My body is constantly changing and progressing itself as a working machine. I can't expect to stay unsolved. I have to put myself back together. The sky is platinum blonde, so bright I avert my eyes. Everything is a staple, a fret, an acre of salt, some twine laid flat on sand with nothing caught inside. I can't expect to stay unsolved. I have to put myself back together. If only I could say what I really wanted to, then I wouldn't feel this unfinished. If the words could escape my mouth and make the statement I wanted them to, maybe I could rest easy.
Sunset. sunset highlights sail by oblong sail. Flimsiest secrets and play together all day.
Fifth Grade Time Capsule by Stephanie Burt was a poem that spoke to me, as I wish I could find the time capsule I made back when I was in fifth grade. Burt listed items such as a rocket ship sketch, earrings, and a t-shirt that she put in her time capsule. Here, I'll be making my own personal time capsule, and for some reason ended up looking like a cake. First, I'll be telling my story through my fifth grade voice. First, I'll be putting in one stick of honey from the Southern Bell Farm. I always get so excited whenever I see honey sticks. They taste so much better than honey from a jar. Next up is one cup of jewelry supplies from Michael's Craft Store. Right now, I'm obsessed with making jewelry. Now we have two pictures of Mr. Rice's egg drop challenge. Hopefully in a few years, I'll remember why I had to put an egg in a container surrounded by Jell-O. That was such a fun day. Here I'm adding half a cup of roller skates from Friday Night Skate. I can't wait to go next Friday and skate with my friends. Next is one cup of foam dinosaur capsules that grow in water. I need to put quite a few in here because if not, they'll all be gone by tomorrow. And lastly, I'm adding in just a dash of my most worn I Love New York t-shirt. Now I'll actually have to find something different to wear to school. At least Mom will be happy about this. Now my time capsule is ready to be buried. Fifth grade has been so much fun. I can't wait for middle school. I'll see this time capsule once I'm in my sophomore year of high school. That seems so far away. This timer represents the years until sophomore year going by. Once time is up, I'm a sophomore. Now the story is being told through my current voice as a current sophomore in high school. Here I am digging my time capsule out of the ground. Time flew by. Luckily, honey doesn't expire. Now I'm going to add onto this time capsule with verse an old Garmin running watch. I broke it when I fell off my bike. It's kind of weird that I like running. Next up, I'll add a little bit of my favorite perfume. And now I'll sprinkle in some iron pills. I wonder if I'll still be taking these when I turn 18. Also, I really wonder where I'll be when I'm 18. Will I still be here in Atlanta? What will my hobbies be? Who will my friends be? And what will I be doing? This is my next stage of life that I'm adding to my time capsule that I started when I was only in fifth grade. Before I put it away, I think I'll go stick a couple of those foam dinosaur capsules in water. I miss those. I'll see this time capsule once again on my 18th birthday. See you soon!
I'm Lilia Tapp, and I'll be playing a short song I composed called Princess Stephanie. It's inspired by the poem Princess Stephanie from the book Advice from the Lights by Stephanie Burt.
Thank you. do not bend their knees. When we go to bed, the redcoats do not sit down.
Nor can they constitute corporations or sew away from us all. Their girls cannot link hands.
Their smooth-faced construction workers in orange jumpsuits with decals for zippers.
Their knights of suzerain lands in smoothly painted on armor.
They do not move.
They cannot bend their knees. Palinode with Playmobil figurines by Stephanie Burt.
To be delicate. To be too big for the helpless, too little, and too important.
What am I gonna wear today? Perfect! No way! No. Not this one.
To have to say,
help me out of this tulle dress.
Perfect.
I miss when I was close with my mom.
Hi, Mommy.
Hi, what do you want for breakfast?
I want chocolate and Nutella and ice cream and cookies and carrots for Mr. Bunny.
How about I make you some homemade waffles instead?
Fine.
Hi, Naomi.
I know how to kiss, but not how to do this slow dance.
Oh! Here you go.
Wow, thanks!
What use is the adult world?
It doesn't have unicorns.
Good evening. I'm here to interview for the office internship.
Oh, good evening. Nice to meet you.
Is there a problem?
What's wrong with your shoes?
Why can't I wear two different colored shoes?
Here are the lines that resonated with me the most. What's up? A place that's way, way overhead. What you can't hear may be deafening somebody else. I would be graceful somewhere. You should be able to see yourself through me. I know no east, no north, no consequence or permanence or blame. That shell is pretty, but that shell is too small for me. If you don't get too close to people, you can't disappoint them, which would be so much worse than letting them disappoint you. Complete in ourselves, we look like scraps of paper anyways. Let us be like the insects that ride on droplets. I want to be found, but I want it to be hard to find. We dismiss whatever comes easiest to us, and we overestimate what looks hard. I made myself.